One of the benefits of using styles in reports and other longer documents is you can quickly and easily create dynamic tables of contents. The same power that lets us see all of these different headings in the navigation pane can be used to generate a table of contents for us. I've added a cover page to our document, and now I want to insert a blank page for a table of contents. So Control-Enter will get me a blank page. And I'm going to go to References, Table of Contents, and I really have several choices. The difference between Automatic Table 1 and Table 2 is 1 says Contents and 2 says Table of Contents. Then you can create a manual table of contents, but I'm going to choose Automatic Table 1, and there is my table of contents, just like that. And if I make any modifications to my document, for example, if we decide that we'd like to have our commercial installation start on a new page, so we do this, hold Control and hit Enter to add a new page. Now, commercial installations is starting on page 4 of 6, but my table of contents says it starts on page 3, but that's okay. Click in the table of contents, choose Update Table, and you can either update the page numbers only if all you've done is move items, or if you actually have changed the names of some of the headings, you could update the entire table. If you're not sure, just update the entire table, and now it's automatically renumbered for me. The assumption behind my standard table of contents is that I'm using Heading 1, Heading 2, Heading 3, Heading 4 styles for my table of contents, or in our case, styles that are based on those. But what if you have some styles that you want to use that aren't Heading 1 and Heading 2, but you still want to use them in the table of contents? Maybe you have a document where the styles were created from scratch, and they're not called K-Head 1 or K-Head 2. They're called My Heading 1, and they really aren't recognized as Heading 1s. Don't worry about that. In that case, you're just going to have an extra step. You're going to go to the table of contents. You're going to go into your table of contents and go to Custom Table of Contents, and you can do this even after it's created. And click the Options button, and it says Build a Table of Contents from Styles. And here I'm saying Heading 1s, Heading 2s, Heading 3s, you can use them, and they'll come in at Level 1, 2, and 3. But notice also that here are our K-Heads. And if these were not listed, if they just didn't show up, and I created my table of contents, I'd be missing lots of stuff. Therefore, what I would need to do in my custom table of contents is go back into the options and go down to my K-heads and say, well, if it's a K-head 1, make it a level 1. If it's a K-head 2, make it a level 2. And then my table of contents will be correct. There are some other choices that you can make in that custom table of contents dialog. You can choose what kind of a tab leader you want to have. You can even modify the styles that are used in the table of contents, which is pretty slick. You just go to Modify, and for TOC Level 1, it's saying a body at 11 point. But if you wanted to have something different, you can just modify the style that is being used for the Level 1 of a table of contents, the Level 2, the Level 3, and so on. Even though it's taken me a few minutes to talk to you about how to create a table of contents, we can actually create it really in about a minute or less. So if I remove my table of contents here, let's do it one more time so you remember how easy this is. You go to References, Table of Contents, choose your table of contents, and you're all done. And if you need to update it, simply click in it and update either numbers or the entire table.